Hey, Gixxerman01 back out in the garage. Today we're going to talk about things you need to make this paint gun perform at its best. We'll go over air compressor, regulator, and water traps. Sorry I haven't put out a video in a while. I've changed jobs, so been pretty busy. And getting back to putting out some good content for my followers and viewers out there. So let's get right into why you need to make this little purple paint gun work its best. So I made a video that kind of covered this before, but I still received a lot of questions about what air compressor to use. This is the air compressor I use. It's a 5-horse Ingersoll Rand 60-gallon tank. You do not have to have an air compressor that is that large and has that much volume or that much capacity. The box clearly states right on it you need 6 CFM at 40 PSI. I'll just say this, you can get away with a smaller air compressor if you're doing smaller projects. You're painting a gas tank on a motorcycle, you could probably use a 2-horse air compressor with a 15 or 20 gallon tank on it for a project of that size. What you're looking for is a air compressor that's going to have enough volume that while you're spraying that it can maintain at least 40 PSI the entire time you're spraying. So while the compressor itself may not keep up, if you have a large enough volume of a tank that as the pressure on the air compressor comes down, that by the time you're done spraying, you're still over 40 PSI in the tank, then that air compressor will get the job done. It's going to struggle. It's going to be hard for that air compressor to do that. And so what'll usually happen, you'll start getting condensation in the tank because the compressor is having to run so hard to do it. So know up front that you'll be dealing with some water issues in your air if you try to run a small air compressor on a larger project. You'll constantly battle having moisture in your air. So there's ways around that too. The best thing is to always oversize your air compressor whenever you're painting so that your air compressor doesn't struggle to keep up. But for those of you out in the garage like me that are doing small projects, a 2 or 3 horse air compressor on a 15 or 20 gallon tank should be able to handle most projects you're going to do. If you're going to paint a car, you're going to want an air compressor like this. Not that you can't get it done with a smaller compressor, but it's going to struggle really hard. So let's just go over the things you can do to combat water or moisture in your air. So two things I've done here is I have a small water trap. You can see there's a little bit of water in it now. So it doesn't take much to drain it off. The other thing I did was on my coming out of my air compressor going into this water trap, I also have a line going straight up to run all my air lines around the rest of the shop. And I put a drop at the bottom of it. And what happens is you get condensation in your tallest run. So that water will condensate or drop down to the bottom of your air line. And then you can drain that off every once in a while to keep moisture out of your paint line. One of the ways you're going to combat water getting to your paint gun is one of these bulbs on the end of the gun. You can pick these up at Harbor Freight. Also, you can pick up one of these little regulators at Harbor Freight. They're right over there by the paint gun. So that is your last line of defense for water in your air going to your paint gun. So there you go, guys. I hope that helps answer some of the questions that I've received on using this little paint gun to paint in your garage. Hope that helped. Thanks for watching. Please click that like and subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video.